Blackstone Publishing presents Persian Gulf Command, A History of the Second World War in Iran and Iraq by Ashley Jackson. This book is read by Stephen Crossley, a member of SAG-AFTRA. This book is dedicated to Sabre, an Australian Kelpie without whose gentle attentions it might have appeared a year ago. Also to Andrew Stewart for his friendship, wisdom, and generosity. Introduction. Early in the Second World War, men who had fought in the 1914-18 Mesopotamia campaign found themselves once again sailing up the Persian Gulf towards Basra on the Shatt al-Arab River. In these desolate and thirsty lands, hundreds of thousands of Indian and British troops were destined to live for many months and some to die. This, once again, was to be a test of British power to survive, to organise and labour in conditions as disheartening as any the world could offer. Here, when the British Commonwealth faced alone the most destructive power in history, when German guns commanded Dover, when the spreading fires of war increased incessantly the need for men and material, an army was to be born, to remain and grow gigantic, hundreds of miles from any major battle. The finest in men and material that the Commonwealth could create or discover was to be poured out in the vast and empty lands between the Caspian and the Persian Gulf. Was this immense expenditure of labour and living wasted? The following pages answer this question, and others relating to the politics of the great powers, the war's grand strategy, and the impact of the conflict on the people of Iran and Iraq. Histories of the war in the Middle East, a problematic appellation, focus overwhelmingly on the campaigns in North Africa. As this book explains, however, the proper Middle East, located farther eastwards, witnessed extensive wartime activity and was a focal point for the ambitions of each of the big three Allied powers. Furthermore, it might be argued that the focus on the British Empire's defence of Egypt rather misses the point that this was primarily intended to protect what lay beyond it, the oil of Iran and Iraq, as well as the vital Suez Canal, which itself was prized not just as the Clapham Junction of Imperial Sea Communications, but as an artery through which Iranian oil could flow. Britain sought to use the war to round off its historic position in the Iran-Iraq region, as did the Soviet Union, while America entered the region in force for the first time, laying the foundations of its puissant post-war presence. Meanwhile, years of German political, economic, and ideological penetration of Iran and Iraq had cultivated close links. During the war, Berlin aimed to incite anti-Allied nationalists and, through the employment of saboteurs, spies, and military assets, to prepare the way for the entry of a victorious Wehrmacht once its enemies had been crushed elsewhere. Though a theatre of extensive activity, the region has not made its way into popular memory of the war and has had minimal impact on the historical record. Reflecting this, Colonel George Heaney, a Survey of India officer sent to the region to map possible invasion routes, wrote that the Allied forces in Persia and Iraq were singularly unsuccessful at catching and holding the limelight. American servicemen dispatched there in their tens of thousands put it more bluntly, referring to themselves as the FBI, the forgotten bastards of Iran. Despite its minor billing in subsequent histories, at the time the region was considered vital by the British because of its oil. It was ranked second only to the British Isles themselves by Winston Churchill and the Chiefs of Staff during the crucial months of 1941-42, when the war hung in the balance. Iran attracted the attention of Franklin D. Roosevelt and Joseph Stalin too, because of its potential as a land bridge over which military aid could flow from the Anglo-American powers to their Soviet ally. The war brought numerous conflicts across the region to a dramatic head. Arab nationalists saw an opportunity to rise up and depose their European masters, and Britain and Iraq, erstwhile allies, turned their guns on each other. Iranian and Iraqi elites vied for power within their states, states that faced uprisings from regional ethno-nationalists wishing to secede. Britain and the Soviet Union prepared for war with each other before becoming allies and jointly.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.